Hello, I'm Natalia Lunata, a fiber artist and your Canadian guide to the vibrant world of textile art and boundless creativity. In this video course, I will teach you how to create a felted snood transformer in just 1.5 hours, quickly, easily, and with high quality lace ornaments on felt. For this work, we will need prepared pre-felt made from 18 micron merino wool, 150 centimeters long and 60 centimeters wide. We will also need a couple of skeins of wool yarn. Additionally, 2 pieces of silk, each 160 centimeters long and 60 centimeters wide, are required. This can be chiffon, silk gauze, or sparse marjolaine silk in colors that complement the wool pre-felt. For felting, you will need a standard set of tools: a terry towel, mosquito netting, vinyl gloves, thick gardening film, sharp scissors, hard soap, a water spray bottle, a wooden or ceramic felting stone, a vibration sander, and bubble wrap as a table covering. The technology for making such a snood is primitively simple. I will show you a method that allows you to make such items easily, quickly, and in large quantities. But this does not mean they will be identical like conveyor products. Different shades of pre-felt and silk, which you will use, and various ornaments will give a great variety of finished products. In this case, no one can limit your creativity and imagination. For those who think they absolutely cannot draw, have never learned, or all previous attempts were unsuccessful, I will show you a little trick if you really want to try making your own unique felted piece. To feel the rhythm of the piece, I recommend you prepare in advance for this creative process. Look at pictures of similar items on various sites like Pinterest or Google search. Don't be afraid to choose photos of knitted items. For example, take a photo of a knitted snood and print it in black and white. Then, with a colored marker, draw the approximate ornament you want to see on your finished felt product. Here's how I did it. On a black and white picture, I drew simple branches and leaves with an orange marker. Even without drawing skills to felt such a piece with a repeating pattern, you need to make a simple sketch. This can be done even by those who can't draw at all. You will be surprised at how much these sketches will help you plan new creative projects. I assure you, this advice has been tested in practice. Hundreds of my students have tried it and everyone succeeded. When you have a sketch on a regular A4 printer paper, draw the repeating ornament you want to see on your finished felt product, either with a ruler or freehand. For the first piece, choose something very simple. To apply a simple plant ornament like mine, stylized branches with leaves, I made a cardboard template. The template is proportional to the size of the snood layout. Thus, I have a sketch, a template scheme, and the template itself. Now I begin the work. The first step will be marking the pre-felt. The pre-felt cloth is folded in half, and in front of me is a rectangle 75 by 60 centimeters. First, I cut along the fold line, resulting in 2 pieces of 75 by 60 centimeters. Then, using the ruler, we mark 15 centimeter strips and cut them. These will be our blanks. We divide the pre-felt width into 5 equal parts, so we get 5 strips of 15 centimeters each. Using a large ruler and either a watercolor pencil, quilting pencil, or a piece of chalk, we apply the markings. We cut the pre-felt folded in half along the marking lines. Thus, I get 10 strips 15 centimeters wide and 75 centimeters long. I want to clarify the dimensions of the film template needed for felting further. It's 75 centimeters plus 10 centimeters, so the template is 85 wide and 80 in height. While editing the video, I sped up the process, but making the entire felted snood takes no more than 1.5 hours. If you lay out the pre-felt from wool yourself, it will, of course, take additional time. Since we will have a repeating pattern, I divide the total number of strips in half, so 10 divided by 2 is 5. One half has 5 strips, and the other half has 5 strips. Each of the 5 will have the same pattern. Now, following the sketch and template, we draw the repeating ornament on the upper part of the pre-felt strips. It's very important that the edges of the strips are straight lines. If there are small protrusions or notches, trim them with scissors. I will cut out the leaves on the pre-felt, those painted orange on the sketch. In the finished product, these areas will be lace-like. Instead of wool, there will be thin, transparent silk. I always try to use available tools as templates to the maximum. For example, to determine the same distance between the leaves, I used a piece of soap, and each time I mark the distance between the leaves with the width of the soap, it's 10 centimeters. You can measure this distance with a ruler, but I show you how I do it on my work table. The leaves I cut from the pre-felt, of course, I do not throw away but set aside. They will be very useful for my next project. In felting, there are practically no waste materials. I repeat the same actions on the second part of the pre-felt strips. Similarly, I outline the leaves with the template and cut them out with scissors. If you plan to make several similar items, you can prepare blanks from pre-felt of different colors in advance, saving a lot of time. In addition to preparing pre-felt blanks, cut yarn pieces that will also become part of the pattern. Since I have 10 pre-felt strips, I cut 20 pieces of yarn to be used, 20 green and 20 orange. The yarn pieces are a bit longer than the height of the snood, about 7 to 10 centimeters on each side, because I want them to be like fringe in the final product. If you don't want this effect, the yarn pieces should be the same width as your pre-felt. When I cut the yarn, I saw that 250-gram skeins left me with plenty of yarn. So, for such a pattern, 100 grams of yarn is enough for 3 snoods. Now we take the silk we plan to use for the wrong side of the snood. Since the silk is beautifully dyed, both sides will be beautiful, so the snood will be double-sided. We take one piece of silk and lay it out on the template. Watch my hands carefully. It's important to lay the silk very evenly so it doesn't skew on the template. If there's a selvage on one side of the thin silk or chiffon, it doesn't need to be trimmed. We start with the basic layout of the snood. The silk laid out on the template extends 10 centimeters beyond the edge of the template on one side, but we place the pre-felt blank very evenly along the edge of the plastic template. You can lay out the pre-felt blanks with different sides depending on the final pattern you want to achieve. Lay the strips 1 centimeter apart. Now we move on to laying the yarn, integrating it into the pattern. If you don't want to leave a silk ruffle along the edge of the pre-felt, trim the silk. I cut the top edge of the silk strip so it aligns with the pre-felt edge. If you want the wool yarn to lay in straight lines, don't forget to moisten these threads with water and stretch them slightly as you lay them out. We first lay the yarn in the gaps between the pre-felt strips. The yarn is thinner than 1 centimeter, so there will still be some free space. Then I lay the yarn in the middle of each strip and add pieces of yarn of the second color. When the yarn pieces are laid out, I spray water over the entire surface of the silk, pre-felt, and yarn layout. A fine mist spray bottle, like those used for misting plants, is very convenient for spraying water. The water droplets will be light and won't shift your ornament layout. Next, I cover the layout with the second piece of silk, which will be the front side. Lay it out the same way. It should extend 8 to 10 centimeters beyond the edge of the template on one side. Align neatly along the bottom of the pre-felt, and you can trim the top part to align with the pre-felt edge. In close-up shots, you can see clearly how the edge of the piece forms, and once more spray water over the second silk layer so the pattern doesn't shift. Along the top edge of the layout, I also carefully trim the silk strip to avoid extra ruffle in the finished product. Cover the layout with a piece of mosquito netting. Gently press the mosquito netting onto the layout with your hands to remove any air bubbles. Thin, flexible mosquito netting can be bought at a hardware store, or you can use synthetic curtain fabric from a fabric store. If you don't have mosquito netting, you can cover the layout with plastic film, but then spray the layout with soapy water instead of plain water. You don't need a lot of water, for each side, including all layers of wool, silk, and yarn, you'll use about 1.5 cups of water, approximately 300 milliliters. So don't create a swamp on your work table. Soak the entire surface with hard soap. I prefer working with hard olive or household soap because it acts like a felting stone while soaping, initiating the felting process immediately. Then gently rub the surface through the netting with your hands to distribute the soap evenly and start the fiber adhesion process. Next, I use a special felting tool, often called a felting stone. This tool helps to rub the layers together more effectively. You can skip additional tools and rub the felt with your palms, but be sure to wear gloves to protect your skin. If needed, add a bit more water and use a vibration sander. Move the sander from place to place, counting to 6 in each spot. Apply no extra pressure. The sander works under its own weight. This process takes only about 3 minutes for the entire surface, ensuring the fine silk and merino fibers bond securely. After sanding one side, turn the layout over and repeat the same steps on the second side of the plastic template. Lay the first layer of silk, followed by the strips with cutout patterns from the pre-felt, the yarn pieces, and the second layer of silk. On the second side, pay special attention to forming the so-called seam on the silk. Watch closely how I do this. It's quite simple. The main thing is not to make the silk overlaps too large and to lay it very evenly without skewing, maintaining straight lines. Carefully check the direction of the pattern on the second side to maintain the overall rhythmic pattern of the ornament. The overlap for the seam on the silk should be about 1.5 centimeters. Spray the entire silk surface with water to keep it from shifting on the template. The process of rubbing and fixing the fibers on this side is no different from the previous one. Lay the mosquito netting, soap, rub with hands, felting stone or iron, remove the netting, and process everything with the vibration sander. Next, continue laying out the pre-felt strips with cutout leaves and arrange the 20 yarn pieces just as you did on the previous side of the template. I sped up the recording during editing because this is the same repetitive sequence of actions. We looked at it more closely on the first side, and here we do the same thing. You already know how. If you don't like or don't want to work with a vibration sander for any reason, you can do the same process by hand. It will just take a bit more time and effort. I save time because I need it for other activities, and the sander is indeed a great helper. you want to make your own pre-felt, use an orthogonal layout for the wool, where two layers of wool are perpendicular to each other. For lace felt, it's better to cut elements from orthogonally laid pre-felt than from pre-felt laid in any other way. You won't have any shifts or deformations. Check the lace windows and ensure that the layout and rubbing are complete. The first and second stages are done. Now I will remove the snood from the template and finish felting it by hand without the template. If you rubbed and sanded well, nothing will fall apart. Although, of course, this is still a blank at the intermediate stage of readiness, I remove excess water with a towel because extra water is not needed at this stage. Just blot with a cotton towel. Carefully, with a confident motion, I pull the template out of the snood without making abrupt movements to avoid damaging it. We proceed to the felting stage. To start, I gently toss the felt, scooping it with my hands from the sides to the center. These tossing movements help settle the felt. I can't specify the exact number of these scooping and tossing movements. It could be 200, maybe 300. It depends on your hand strength. But don't hit the felt against the table too hard. Be gentle. Next, I take a piece of IKEA film and continue the same felting movements on it. This film is more textured, and felting on it goes very well. I think you can find similar films in other household stores and dollar stores. After additional felting, I again remove excess moisture with a towel. I straighten the yarn, all the fringes and the edges of the cuts. From time to time, straighten the snood, stretching it slightly in height. As you felt, you will notice the felt loses its fluffiness, becoming thinner and more resilient. As felting progresses, the sound of the felt will also change. It becomes more resonant. It no longer feels like loose dough, but gains firmness and resonance. You will learn to feel the felt with your fingertips and hear it. The overall shrinkage of the felt in this project, considering the silk, is about 20%. However, the actual shrinkage of the felt could be much greater, but the silk strips prevent the item from becoming too small. Next, I rinse the snood in room temperature water, wring it out in a towel, and dry it on a horizontal surface. Then I steam it with a hot iron. In conclusion, I want to show you the ornament variations and the finished product as it looks on the model. This snood transformer can be worn in various ways, with different hats as a scarf, as a headscarf, as a turban, and even as a vest. An important point, if you want this snood transformer to be worn as a vest, to fit a bust size up to 100 centimeters, the layout on the template should be 2.5 times the circumference of your head. If your clothing size is larger, then your initial blank should be wider, adjusted according to your bust measurement or your clothing size. I wish you new creative ideas and plenty of free time for your favorite hobby. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to my channel. Ask questions in the comments and share the link with your friends. See you at the next masterclass.